very much for the introduction, and I'm very happy to be here with all of you and all of our participants. I will share my screen, so maybe it's the first time today that someone is presenting by sharing the screen. Can you see my screen properly? Yeah. Okay, so as Fabrício said, my name is Thais Gussomano. I'm a medical doctor specialized in space physiology and aerospace medicine and also telehealth. I'm here with Marianne Upichard, which is the administrative director of InnovSpace. This is a company that both of us started and established in Britain, in the United Kingdom, back in 2018. I'm the CEO, she's the admin director, and one of our first projects was Kids to Mars, that I will present today. So just very briefly, InnovSpace is a think tank company that develops global, inclusive, diverse, and disruptive scientific projects and educational initiatives. We have four main areas, which is human space exploration, aviation medicine and aerospace physiology, humans in extreme environments, and telemedicine and digital health. And we take these four areas and we work in four different ways. We have research, development, innovation consultants as one of our, let's say, ways to work. We have entrepreneurship and technology transfer. We have a huge area of education with lectures, courses, webinars, scientific events, and training. And of course, we have outreach projects and activities. When we talk about outreach projects, they are all open access. So we do not, of course, charge our clients, which is basically society, schools, museums, cultural centers, and so on. This is very much in alignment with our ethos, our principle of the company of InnovSpace, which is space without borders. We want to be extremely inclusive, as I said, very, very global, and bring this diversity of mankind to our projects. So Kids to Mars, as I said, was one of our first projects. And we designed a way that we'd like to create a symbolic representation of humanity by involving all 193 United Nations member states in a space project that is related to the human exploration of planet Mars. With that, of course, as we are dealing with knowledge, we are also creating an open access reservoir of knowledge related to planet Mars and human missions to the red planet. And we do that, at least that's how we decide, let's say, to have this symbolic representation, through videos from kids and adolescents ranging from 6 to 18 years old from all over the world, asking questions about Mars and the Mars exploration, and that would be answered by scientists, astronauts, analog astronauts, and so on. So this is a very global, inclusive, and diverse project that aims to democratize space science, especially the exploration of Mars. We then created this site. It's called Kids to Space. And it's not Kids to Mars because the idea was to expand it under this umbrella of Kids to Space, to have Kids to Moon, Kids to Orbit, Kids to Cosmos, and so on. So this is the first step, we believe, of a huge project. And Kids to Mars now, we divided in Kids to Mars as a map, you know, so we can see all the countries that are engaging or are part of the project, and the Mars Encyclopedia. I will just show that in a moment. So this is the map, and you can see that these red dots mean that these specific countries are part of the Kids to Mars project. You see here just an example of a girl from Iceland asking a question, and then an analog astronaut answering the question. So if you click on these dots, you can open up these videos with questions and answers. But then we realize that if you want to go by to search, to understand manned trips, a human trip to Mars, we need to also divide it by topics. Otherwise, you have to click all these dots to try to find, let's say, some information that you want. Then you create the encyclopedia. So it is an open access encyclopedia, again, based on the video. So you have the videos there with questions and answers, but divided in five topics. Planet Mars itself, travel to Mars, living on Mars, animals and plants on Mars, and health and well-being of humans on Mars. So these are let's say, the four main topics, and we place the questions in each topic. We also added a blog, a kids blog. So kids that are part of the project, sometimes they are not part of the Kids to Mars project in terms of asking questions, but they want to be somehow part of the project, they can write a blog that we publish on the site of Kids to Space. In general, it's broader than just the exploration of Mars. It's more like space as a whole. We have some supporters. Now we have Mega, which is response for the site, the Kids to Space site, and other initiatives. Ethereal Media, which help us a lot with the video production and so on. And we have other partners that are related to education or Mars analog missions. And one of them is EdSnaps, which is a not-for-profit company set in New York. And as we are covering 193 member states of the United Nations, we would like to have the video subtitled with in the six languages of the United Nations. Okay, English is there already, Portuguese because I'm Brazilian is there already, but we want also Chinese, Spanish, Russian, Arabic, and French. So this is the partnership with EdSnaps is through this the translations of the videos, and it's called A Trip to Mars in 600 Videos. We believe that you are going to end up with about 600 videos or so. And this is a company that is a 501(c), which accepts donation and gives tax exemptions through that. Our first project was with Ilaria Sinelli as the commander of MDRS mission, which is an analog mission in the Utah desert. It was called Crew 185, and we had one kid representing every continent on Earth. So it was our first step, except for Antarctica, all continents were represented by kids asking questions about the analog mission and the trip to Mars and so on. And then we had another mission called Kids to Mars Mission 2, with Austrian Space Forum, Amadi 18, that was set in Oman. And again, we had all the questions and answers from questions from kids and answers from the analog astronauts from the Oman mission. And then we created this third mission, which is called Kids to Mars Mission 3, which is a continuous mission because many times you do not have analog missions going on, or especially now with the COVID-19 was a problem this year. And so we decided to create this Mission 3, which is a continuous mission because we connect the kids' questions with space scientists and experts that are willing to, let's say, participate in the project. Here you have an example of scientists from the NASA Jet Propulsion Lab and another one from the European Space Agency. Another one from NASA. So we have we connect to a network of friends, colleagues, and professionals that are happy to answer the questions. Also, we have some countries that, in order to select the kids for the participation in the project, and in general, we aim for two kids, one a boy and a girl from each country. As I said, it's a symbolic representation. You cannot have all kids from every single country asking questions. So at least we have one boy and one girl from each country. Sometimes they start competitions, they organize the competition. So here you have two examples. One is going on, in fact, in Israel to select two videos to send to us. And in October, during the Space Week, we had the competition for in Pakistan that also selected two videos and sent to us. We were and then we found, let's say, we connected these questions to these kids' questions to experts to be answered. Sometimes it is not through competitions, not through invitation, but it is through lectures that I give or other people that are connecting of space give to schools, and then the school some they select, let's say they also have a kind of competition, but they select the questions and send to us. So this is an example of a question, of a lecture that I gave virtually to Brazil, to a school in Brazil that then select two or three questions and send to us. This is another example of ways to, let's say, advertise, market the project. This was a lecture very recently given by a colleague, a friend from Angola, Marco Romero, who talked about the Kids to Mars project, and he's very keen in helping this program. I use also this slide to show this small robot here. We are creating mascots for the Kids to Mars project. This one is our African mascot, and it will have lots of different, let's say, applications in terms of how we are going to use the mascot. And it was created with a very African style, and we want to have different mascots from other continents or countries, and then create this network of mascots that will help kids to understand about trips to Mars and the other aspects related to space. I was invited to be a mentor, a voluntary mentor for the Space for Women Network and of the United Nations, and I invited my mentees to participate in this project, the Kids to Mars project, and in fact in another project called Valentina, which is a way to create, to empower, I would say, young girls and female professionals towards the area of STEM. And so these two projects, they overlap sometimes. And so these three mentees that I have are part of these two projects, including Kids to Mars. And it's our way to promote and collaborate with these three Sustainable Development Goals of the United Nations. Number 4, quality education. Number 5, gender equality. And number 10, reduced inequalities. So just to finalize, we have now achieved 47 countries out of the 193 UN member states, and here we have the flags and the names of the countries. In fact, we have, I can tell you that just between yesterday and today, we have two more countries coming in, and so very soon we are going to get to 50 countries, and as soon as we get 50 countries, we are thinking to have a kind of celebration, and advertise that even more. If there is any way that you can help, of course, we need experts and scientists and astronauts, analog astronauts, and so on, to answer the questions. We have, would you like to have sponsors for donations, as we know that it is, we need, it's open access, and then we need some, of course, money to run the project, and any voluntary contribution will be fine. So thank you very much for your attention. I hope I have presented, I hope I have, how can I come back here? Okay. A kind of overview of the project, and of course I'm happy to, me and Mary in fact are gonna be here the whole day, and I'm happy to answer questions or connect with you all. Thank you.